big news today for Bitcoin. So much going on. We have big news out of Dubai. We have big news out of Germany. We have big news out of New York City. We have big news out of Brazil. Everything big news except for the price of Bitcoin, which is still kind of meh. So we'll be diving into the technicals as well, looking at Bitcoin, trying to figure out what the heck is going on with the old Bitcoin right now. My name's Lark. Every day I make videos talking about cryptocurrency investing. So if that's a topic that you would like to learn some more about, make sure that you subscribe to the channel. Gently tap on the thumbs up button for the YouTube algorithm, not too viciously, just a gentle tap is all it takes. And of course, click on the notification bell to know when I put out a new video. So let's go ahead and turn over to the charts to get started off with. Okay, so into the charts we go. As we can see, Bitcoin has come back down around $32,500 at the time of recording this video after having a nice move up yesterday. We almost got to $35,000. Of course, that was just a nice recovery bounce after the meteoric crash we had for Bitcoin down to $28,800 the other day. Obviously, we're not even anywhere near the key moving averages that we need to be closing over. I mean, you know, the 200-day simple moving average is up at $43,500. The 200-day exponential moving average is around $40,000. I'd be happy if we retook the 200 EMA. That would be a beautiful sign for Bitcoin. We aren't even close to that right now. But perhaps we are getting ready to make a move in that direction. See, this could have been our Wyckoff spring moment here. Now, if that is the case, if that was our spring moment there, then we could actually be getting ready to come back down here, as you can see, for the test before pushing higher. So if we got our spring there, we're going to find out in the not-so-distant future, because if we get the test and start pushing higher, that would confirm that we are in phase C of the Wyckoff accumulation schematic. We can, of course, watch for that to come in here. So what would that put us at in terms of price? So we can see that 1, 2, 3 times the price of Bitcoin has found support right in this area. And of particular interest to us is, of course, watching for the second test area. So that would be right around here. Either one of these you could consider to be that situation. That would put us for around $31,000 for a potential retest here before pushing higher, retesting that support before pushing the price higher. Not saying it has to come down there, but that I think is an interesting area to be watching out for right now as a confirmation of this Wyckoff pattern. If it does, then let's expect the price to be pushing a bit higher afterwards. So we're keeping a close eye on this. You know, the whales, you might be thinking, well, Lark, come on. I mean, if all the whales know that we're watching this Wyckoff pattern right now, if, you know, we caught them up here, right? We found out what the whales were doing, and we've caught on to what they're doing. So why would they so transparently do it now? Well, most people will not believe it. Most people are still thinking that we're going to go down to $10,000. So when the situation happens, and we've seen the charts, I've shared so much on-chain data with you guys about the capitulation that has happened. So much new money. So many people who bought Bitcoin in December, in January, in February, in March, particularly people buying Bitcoin at $40,000, $50,000, $60,000, $65,000, they have sold, they have capitulated. I know, it's tough. You buy Bitcoin at $65,000 a month later, you're down 50% on your investment. Ouchies. The big money knows this. The whales know this. The institutions know this. One thing that I was talking about earlier this year is that the entry of these institutional players has brought a new form of market manipulation with it. And we can see the big money. This is how they play the game. Right? They push it up. Then we see all this FUD pushing the price back down. They accumulate, getting ready to push it back up again. So we're keeping a close eye on this. Let's see if we get the confirmation that this was indeed the Wyckoff spring here, and if it will push us higher. If that is the case, we could see Bitcoin closing over potentially one of these moving averages in the next couple of weeks. So keeping a keen eye on that. By the way, if you want to buy yourself some Bitcoin, maybe some Ethereum, some Polkadot, some Cardano, some Polygon, whatever your fancy might be, you need to get yourself an account over on Binance. It is the best cryptocurrency exchange in the world. And if you use the link down below in the description to start your account, then you're going to get 10% off of your trading fees and up to $700 in trading bonuses if you're trading futures over on Binance. Now let's talk about the news. Let's talk about the big, exciting, really good news that's happening right now. I know we've had so much negative news, so I want to share some good news with you today. Some things to just remind you about the big picture, about what's actually happening in this market, the things that are starting to take place. To give you that perspective, that long term, we are going to go so much higher than, you know, $32,000. Not saying we're going to go straight there. There's going to be a lot of turbulence on the way. But here's a big story for you. The Bitcoin ETF in Brazil has officially started to trade. This is very exciting. We covered the story on the channel that it was approved about maybe 6 weeks ago, 7 weeks ago. Well, it has now started trading. I'm very excited about this. Brazil is an incredibly big economy. The Brazilian equity markets are the 14th biggest in the world. They're around 1% of global equity markets, which I know may not sound like the biggest, you know, considering that the US markets are like 54% of all global equity markets. But hey, 1%. That's big. That's, you know, it's a $1 trillion equity market. So we are going to see money coming into this Brazilian Bitcoin ETF. Keep in mind, Canada is only around 2% of the global equity markets, and they've got 3 Bitcoin ETFs currently trading on their exchanges. And those Bitcoin ETFs have now picked up tens of thousands of Bitcoin. Very, very popular investment products with Canadian investors. I'm sure that the Bitcoin ETFs in Brazil, will also be very popular with investors. These are great financial products because, look, regardless of how easy it is to actually go and buy Bitcoin on Coinbase or some other exchange, whatever local Brazilian exchanges might be, a lot of people, they're still, you know, like, oh, I don't know if I want to use these new exchanges, then I have to, you know, withdraw it and put it on a hardware wallet, you know, and be in charge of my private keys and all that stuff. A lot of people just don't want that, right? They want to be able to get an exchange traded product like a Bitcoin ETF, add it to their investment portfolio as part of, you know, their brokerage account that they already have. We've covered the numbers here on the channel in terms of just adding, you know, like 1 or 3 or 5 or even 10% of your portfolio into Bitcoin. The returns over time are incredible, incredible. So you can add just 1% of your portfolio into Bitcoin, and over a multi-year period, your portfolio is going to have exponentially bigger gains versus having a portfolio with zero Bitcoin exposure. This is the value proposition for a lot of these people who are stuck on brokerage accounts, don't want to deal with all the nonsense of private keys and all that stuff. They just want exposure to Bitcoin. They want a really easy way to do it. So they're going to go to their brokerage account that they've always used, buy a Bitcoin ETF, and get in the game. The important thing with these Bitcoin ETFs, they're physically backed, right? It's not like the CME and their junky paper contracts that lets Wall Street, you know, trade against the price going up and down with having zero freaking exposure to Bitcoin. So ETFs are a good thing for the market. And I think that having Canadian Bitcoin ETFs and Brazilian Bitcoin ETFs, and probably soon Australian and South African Bitcoin ETFs, are going to help the USA get Bitcoin ETFs coming out at some point. Come on, America. They actually just rejected, they delayed. Very careful that it was not a rejection, it was a delayed. They delayed another Bitcoin ETF application until like August, so they keep just kicking the can down the road, but they have 12 applications in the USA right now for Bitcoin ETFs. When it gets passed, not if, it's not an if question. We have a new SEC, they're crypto friendly. Got 12 applications in from incredibly serious companies. We're going to get a Bitcoin ETF in the USA. It is coming. Okay, so enough of that. Enough ETF news. Let's talk about this. First ever Middle Eastern Bitcoin fund launches in Dubai. This is great news as well. Obviously, Dubai is the financial center of the Middle East. So seeing a Bitcoin fund getting launched there, this is big news. This is exciting news. This is another great way for money to flow into Bitcoin, right? These kind of funds have proven to be very, very popular. You can look at the New York Digital Investment Group, NYDIG, their Bitcoin funds. We've seen a lot of other Bitcoin funds being launched by Galaxy Digital and quite a few other different companies. They're super popular. They're super popular. Institutions, millionaires, billionaires, they just want to throw money at Bitcoin. They don't want to deal with all the stuff, right? They just want to say, hey, here's $50 million, put it into Bitcoin for me. And that's what happens. These are these Bitcoin funds that are accruing incredible amounts of Bitcoin right now. So this is great. This is great. I'm very excited to see more availability coming for more money to flow into the market. That's exactly what these Bitcoin funds are doing. Dubai, of course, is an area where we're seeing a lot of cryptocurrency growth, a lot of cryptocurrency companies moving into Dubai, a lot of influencers moving into Dubai, attracted by the low tax rates. Now let's move on to the next story. Now this was actually printed, as you can see, back April 29th, 2021, but it's very relevant today for a reason, because here's the story. In Germany, new legislation enabling managers of the most popular institutional investment funds, Spezial funds, probably mispronounced that in German, but you know, you guys get the point. This new law is going to allow them to allocate 20% of their funds to cryptocurrency assets. Now this is going to come into force on the 1st of July. 1 week from now, all of these 4,000 different funds in Germany will be able to invest up to 20% of their portfolios into cryptocurrency assets. Now, okay, sure, let's keep it real. Not all 4,000 are gonna get into crypto. Maybe 400 will, maybe 200 will. That represents 5% of those funds. Heck, maybe 100 will. That represents 2.5% of those funds. How many billions of dollars do those 2.5%, those 100 funds control? A lot of money here. We're talking about, you know, billions of dollars that can come into the cryptocurrency market, buy Bitcoin, buy Ethereum, add these products into their investment portfolios. That's a lot of potential money that can come into the market right there. So it's a really exciting bit of legislation. We talked about it on the channel a few months ago, but it's happening in just a few days, 7 days away from this law coming into effect. Now it's not gonna be an immediate effect. Like on the 1st of July, we're gonna see like $20 billion of the Bitcoin market buys. No, I mean, you gotta keep it real. These fund managers, they don't do $20 billion market buys. They're gonna come in and they're gonna buy, you know, $5 million of the Bitcoin on the first, another $5 million on the second, another $5 million on the third, building these positions up. But this is really exciting because it does mean that German funds can finally join the party in a very serious way and start piling money into the crypto market. So these guys are representing billions and billions of dollars worth of potential money that can flood into the crypto market. And the final story for today, New York City's mayoral frontrunner Eric Adams says that the city will become a center of bitcoins. Nice. Obviously, he still needs to win that election, but if he does, he's seen the excitement building around Miami and what the mayor of Miami has done to start to make Miami into a Bitcoin city. And look, I think New York, it's the, of course, you know, one of the biggest financial centers in the world, incredibly big. But the problem with New York is that back in the early days of Bitcoin, you had a district attorney who was very anti-Bitcoin, and they passed something called the Bit Law. Now, the Bit Law, so if you live in New York City, you probably know how stupid it is trying to get access to cryptocurrencies. So what happened? This law was passed, and essentially it made it just incredibly hard for any companies to get licensed to operate a Bitcoin business in New York. So if you're a New York-based cryptocurrency investor, or think about all of the businesses and the funds, and yeah, the funds, it's easier for them to get around things. They are, you know, much more flexible than your regular retail investors, but still, it's made Bitcoin adoption in one of the world's biggest financial centers unnecessarily slow with this draconian bit law. So my hope is that if this guy gets elected and he wants to really make New York City a center of Bitcoin, then this law is going to be repealed. We're going to see common sense legislation brought in that's going to encourage the development of this industry in New York City. So this would be really cool. Like I said, he still has to win the election, but hopefully he follows through on this promise and does actually hop on board with this and follow in Miami's footsteps and say, hey, let's put New York on the map as a Bitcoin city, a city where you can pay for things in Bitcoin, you know, whether it be buying something down at your local shop or paying your taxes or paying your parking fines or whatever it might be, and a city that at a legislation level welcomes the Bitcoin industry with open arms instead of making it unnecessarily difficult with red tape for Bitcoin businesses to exist in New York. So I'm very excited about that. I hope that all that stuff comes to happen. But anyway, I just wanted to share this video with you today because there's good things happening. Take the big picture in here. There's always these positive stories. I know all this China FUD has been freaking people out recently, but things are just changing right now. The miners are already moving. We've already had the stories of miners moving to Kazakhstan, miners moving to Texas. So things are happening. Positive things are happening to the market. And even if the price is still kind of suffering, the long-term picture here for cryptocurrencies, it's not going anywhere. It's only getting better all of the time. Anyway, your question for today: what do you think is going to be the next country to approve a Bitcoin ETF? Is the USA going to be it? Are they finally going to get it together at the SEC and say, let's approve a Bitcoin ETF? Or is it going to be Australia? Is it going to be South Africa? Maybe it's going to be a European country like France that comes out and approves Bitcoin ETFs. Curious to know your opinion down below in the comment section. Thanks so much for watching today's video, and peace out till next time.